Hello crafty friends, it's Susie Chocolate here. Hope you're liking what you can see on screen as I'm going to talk you through how I made this gorgeous mixed media heart.
So this is how I started off. I'm feeling a little bit more comfortable now doing the mixed media. I'm so used to doing cards that I'm not, you know, this is totally out of my comfort zone, but I've made the gold one that is on my YouTube channel and on my blog. And today I'm just going to take you through how I've done it. And if anybody's interested in actually seeing the process, then I'll quickly whip up a video of how I did the layering up of the embossing powder so that you can see that. I'm quite happy to do that because it doesn't take very long at all. But I started off with a grey board, just a little grey board heart. It's 4 inches by just over 4.5, I think. I coated it with a few layers of this Liquitex acrylic titanium white paint. It's in a tube, which I found, it's the first time I've used white acrylic paint, and I found it was really helpful being in a tube, because you can just take a little bit out or you can squirt some onto your glass mat or whatever. So that was really helpful. But anyway, I did 2 or 3 coats both sides with this little brush, and just so that it was totally covered and it had a nice white covering. And then I used my Versamark pad on top of the white ink. As you can see, it's got a bit green there from some of the stuff I was, some of the embossing powders. But I stamped it out, so it was a really good covering. And then I started off layering up all the different colours that I'd chosen. And so these are the colours that I chose as my palette. I wanted it to be this is what I was working towards, this sort of green on this little butterfly that that I found in my stash. And so I ordered this Wow embossing powder, and it's called Primary Beautiful, which you can see there. And it is a really, really good match. And so that's a translucent, not an opaque type of embossing powder. And then I think I got these from a charity shop. I've got a green, a red and a blue, and it's really quite big granules. It's not a fine granule of embossing powder, and so I thought that that went quite well with it. So I was going to mix them together. And so I, on top of the Versamark, I just sprinkled from the pot some of the Beautiful, and then obviously knocked it off and heat embossed it and melted it. And then while it was really hot, I sprinkled a little bit of, well, this was really, the melting was hot. I sprinkled a little bit of this on just to see what it was going to look like. And I liked it. It looked really nice. And so then while that was hot, I sprinkled some more of the Beautiful on it and just took it to as far close to the edge as I felt that I wanted to have a little bit of a white rim ish around the edge. And so I didn't go right the way over it. And then I think after I'd done those three, I let it dry so that I could, you know, have a little feel and see what the texture was coming up like. And it was getting really shiny. And so I thought that I would drop in some space dust. This is another Wow embossing powder, and it's got lots of little bits of purple, blue, black, and some clear, very big granules of clear in there. I sprinkled just a tiny little bit of that just to see what was going to happen. And when I put the heat tool on it, it remelted this, and then all this beautiful, I don't know if you can see it there, all these beautiful different little specks started to sink in to the greens, and it looked really beautiful. So I just sprinkled a few more of those over. I tapped the Versamark in some, you know, I didn't cover it all over, I just tapped it in the places that I wanted it to cover, and then I sprinkled a little this on with my fingers and then heat melted it, and it started to look really beautiful. And so I think I then just tapped another little bit of this over while that was hot, and then I had another little bit of green just to, you know, make up the pattern, the colours that I felt I wanted, and it was looking really, really good and getting nice and thick as well. Then I popped on top of that some brilliant sparkle snow cap, which is just a white sparkly glitter embossing powder. And so that went, I sort of put that through the middle, melted that, and that then sunk into this as well with this. And it was really, really good. And then I did 5 coats of clear. Well, this is detailed, but it doesn't need to be detailed because it's the only one I've got, a clear embossing powder. And so you could, you know, a chunky clear would be fine. But I just covered the total, I let it dry and cool off. I covered it with the Versamark and I sprinkled a really good coating of the clear embossing powder on and knocked it off, melted it. While it was still hot, put some more on, put some more on, put some more. I did 5 layers to finish it off, and then it had got a really beautiful thickness. It looked almost like acrylic or glass. Yeah, and I was really, really excited. And so I felt a lot more comfortable doing that, because I think that that relates to what I would have done on sentiment, where I've built up the layers on a sentiment of embossing powder to make them look like enamel. And so, so once that was done, I let that dry overnight. And so that's all the embossing powders out of the way. Excuse me. I've got a tickle coming now. And then I found lots of little bits and pieces. Now, these are the bits that I didn't use on the heart that you've already seen. But I just want to show you. This was red and yellow, I think. And I've just coated it in some of the white acrylic. And you can still sort of see the colour through. There's a little bit of pink colour coming through there from the dark red. And this little dog was brown with a red heart, and I just give him a coat. His little bone was brown, and this bird was sort of a creamy coloured, and I do want to use that. You'll see that I tried to put it in this, but I'm not sure. I still might put it on. Anyway, let me just show you. Excuse me. This is how it turned out. And so these are the these white things that I painted, the lily and the daffodil, the forever friends. Underneath there is a little, I don't know if you can see, underneath there is a little oxo. If you can see how well it is glistening and how thick it is, it's beautiful texture. And then this is texture paste that I put through a little stencil. And then obviously the butterfly on the top, which is an acetate butterfly. And then I painted these little white bits with some of my homemade shimmer powder, which is Cosmic Shimmer Mica Pearlescent Powder in Surgical Spirit, because I haven't got any of the isopropyl alcohol, or whatever it's called, isopropyl, that's what it is. And so yeah, and so then I painted these with a little paintbrush using some of that, just to give that a little sheen, to because they looked a bit dull and flat. They look a bit dull and flat, yeah, like that. And so once that green was done, I then used this card making magic Christina Griffiths stencil. I used this on the bottom of the heart because it fitted on there absolutely perfectly, And then you get this beautiful little, it's like a vine of leaves and hearts. And I thought that was a good start. Laid my flowers on, laid the Forever Friends on, and put the butterfly in the middle. And that was it, basically. And so, yeah, it took me, I don't know, a couple of hours, I suppose, this time, which is a lot quicker than the gold one I did. This is the texture paste I used, Dreamweaver stencil embossing paste that my friend, good friend Elizabeth sent me, because she wasn't using it. And so I thought I'd try and put that to some good use. And excuse me, I've got a tickle. I need a cup of tea. And so, yeah, that's how I did all that part of it. And so now I'll just take you through a little bit of a video which I made as I was trying to organise and talk myself through what I've done, and just so that I could go back and look at it and see what I thought about the positioning. So I always find it's really helpful for me to take a picture of it and then look at it, or take a video and then look at it. And then I actually get the perspective of what other people are going to see, because sometimes I look at it and think, oh, I don't know, is that right, is it not? So yeah, it's that's what I found really helps me, and I do that with my cards as well now. And so yeah, let's just go on to a little bit of video, and then you'll see where I've added this little bird in. I sat him in there, and I still might sit him in there, I don't know. It's quite, for the lady I've made this for, one of my good friends, it's quite, excuse me, what is the word, poignant to have a little bird in there, because it means something to us both. And so, yeah, if you've got any questions, or if you'd like me to see the if you'd like to see how I've done the embossing layers, then please let me know in the comments, and I'll just knock up a quick video, it won't be long, and add it to this tutorial. And so off we go.
Here it is. None of it is stuck on. I've just laid it on, and obviously the butterfly is flapping about, but hopefully you can see all the different twinkles. Yeah, it's got loads of like purple and grey and silver bits around the edge, and then I put some brilliant white sparkle through the middle, and then covered it all again with the embossing. I love it. I think it's amazing. And hopefully you can see the size of it now sitting in my hand.